Hello and welcome to today's video where I'll be covering my webcomic process in Clip Studio Paint. In the previous video, I went over some of Clip Studio Paint's comic making materials and some ways to use them. Today I'll be discussing some more ways you can make your own materials, including how to create your own brushes and textures. Links to additional tutorials and information for everything mentioned in today's video will be down in the description. Before making your own brushes in Clip Studio Paint, there are a few basic things you need to know. For starters, there are two types of brushes you can make: brushes that use your selected color, and brushes that use their own color. As you can see here, this hatching brush I use for backgrounds uses my main selected color. If I change this color to something else, then the brush will change too. On the other hand, this brush I use for decorations always uses the same color, regardless of what I have chosen. Both types of brushes can be useful depending on what results you're looking for, but the method of creating each is slightly different and important to distinguish if you plan on making your own brushes for comics. To start, draw out the shape you'd like for your brush tip. The brush tip is the image that's used to shape your brush. In this example, I'd like to make another background hatching brush, so I drew a scribble. I've drawn the brush tip at a decently large size too, so it can be scaled up and down without losing any quality. The next step will dictate what type of brush you end up making. Clip Studio Paint determines whether your brush uses its own colors or selected colors through the expression color settings in the layer property panel. In essence, the expression color you choose will give Clip Studio Paint's brush engine instructions on how you want the brush to behave. If the expression color is left on color mode, then it'll use whatever colors you have on the canvas and it won't change. In this example, since I drew the brush tip in black, I won't be able to draw in any color besides black while using the brush tip. To make the brush change depending on your selected colors, you'll want to make sure your brush tip has been drawn in black and then switch the expression color to gray. As you can see, a symbol will appear on your layer once the expression color has been switched to gray. Once your brush tip looks like how you'd like it to, register it as a material by going to Edit, Register Material, Image. As I mentioned in the previous video, this is the panel where you can save materials and designate what they're for. To turn this image into a brush shape, make sure you check the Use for Brush Tip Shape box under the preview image. Tag it appropriately and save it somewhere you'll remember. I chose to save mine under the Brush subfolder of the Image Material folder, since that's where all the other brush tips are saved by default. Now we can go ahead and make the brush. To do this, duplicate a pre-existing brush by going to the plus sign button at the bottom of the subtool panel. I recommend duplicating a brush that behaves closely to how you'd like your new brush to behave. For this example, I duplicated one of Clip Studio Paint's default decoration brushes that behaves like a stamp, since that's the effect I'm going for. With the brush duplicated, go to the wrench icon in the Tool Property panel to open up the Subtool Detail window. Head to the Brush Tip category. This is where you can replace the old brush tip with your new one. Select the old tip and delete it, then click the open space to locate and load in your new brush tip. Now your brush tip will be ready. You can adjust it however you like using the other menu settings. There are lots of other customization options available to make your brush unique, but for now, we'll consider this brush complete. Having your own custom brushes for your comic is not only a great way to save time, but it also helps give it a more personal touch that can really enhance the visual style. Over time, I've replaced a lot of the default or downloaded brushes with ones I made myself, and it has really helped my webcomic gain its own special style. In the last video, I mentioned using texture overlays to add some visual interest to your comic pages. Just like brushes, you can make your work more personal by making your textures from scratch. However you choose to make it, you could turn your image into a paper texture by registering it as a material. Like before, head to Edit, Register Material, Image, and give your paper texture the appropriate tags and location. This time, however, you'll want to make sure that the Use for Paper Texture checkbox is selected. To make sure your texture can fit in any size page, check the Scale Up and Down and Tiling boxes. Setting the tiling to repeat will make it a tiled pattern that can be extended as much as you like. After registering your material, go to its location in Materials and drag it onto your canvas. You can rotate and stretch it as much as you like, and it'll tile to fit your canvas no matter where you place it. When you have it positioned how you like it, go to the Layer Property panel and click the Overlay Texture button. This will turn your texture into a proper overlay. Another great source of materials for your comic that I recommend checking out is the Clip Studio Assets page. I've also uploaded some of my own personal brushes and textures to my profile, which is also linked down below if you'd like to check them out. Those are the basics of how you can use Clip Studio Paint's materials to help with making your webcomic. In the next episode, I'll be going over how you can use auto actions to make complicated drawing tasks a lot easier. Check the description below for my social media links and more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.